Here now is Rudy Giuliani. Mr. Mayor, let's get your response to what Madam Clinton has had to say.
Well, it's the most incredible act of hypocrisy I've ever seen. I mean, the woman basically voted to give 20% of our plutonium to Russia. Her crooked foundation got $150 million. $150 million. Her husband got a $2.5 million speaking fee. I don't know. It kind of looks like bribery. It smells like bribery. It sounds like bribery. I'm not saying it is, but it comes awful close. Plus, if anybody was guilty of obstruction of justice, it's her. I mean, she did away with 33,000 emails. She destroyed phones. She had a guy doing it with hammers. And she bleach bid her server. President Trump didn't do any of that. In fact, she's not telling the truth. He turned everything over to the special counsel. Didn't obstruct anything. There's no obstructive act that was found, even by Mueller.
You know, Mr. Mayor, I was shocked that she would even go there. I mean, in light of the fact that she had these servers, what you just ran through, that litany of things that even Jim Comey went on television to basically say, yeah, this was stuff she shouldn't have done, but her intent wasn't there. But basically, he outlined a criminal case for her, and then for her to come and do it, I mean, that takes some real audacity, don't you think?
Well, Mike, you know, every one of those acts I just mentioned is the typical thing you prove as evidence of intent. There's nothing more powerful in an obstruction case than destruction of evidence, which wasn't present in the Trump situation. Nor was there an underlying crime. He was found to be exonerated of collusion. That whole Russian thing turned out to be a hoax. Her campaign played a role in promulgating that hoax. They paid $1.1 million for the phony steel dossier. The only person who actually apparently has done business with the Russians is Hillary. And I think she's going to be in for quite an extensive investigation, and she doesn't have Jim Comey to fix the case for her this time.
Mr. Mayor, the president weighed in on this today. He had a message to the Democrats in Congress, and it basically was this. Bring it on. Let's watch. Get your reaction afterwards.
The subpoena is ridiculous. I have been the most transparent president and administration in the history of our country. I thought after 2 years, we'd be finished with it. No, now the House goes and starts subpoenaing. They want to know every deal I've ever done. We're fighting all the subpoenas. Look, these aren't like impartial people. The Democrats are trying to win 2020.
Mr. Mayor, the floor is yours. Your response.
Well, this is a completely political harassment. I mean, anybody can see through it. Jerry Nadler, Schiff, Cummings, they've all prejudged the case a year ago. And unfortunately, because they have an inability to control their mouths, we have plenty of statements that he's guilty of obstruction, guilty of collusion. Adam Schiff has evidence of collusion that he never turned over to Mueller, apparently, or he was lying, one or the other. So these are not impartial arbiters, and there's a very good ground to resist these subpoenas as illegitimate hearings by the Congress. This is a political hearing. It doesn't serve any legislative purpose. It doesn't really even serve an investigative purpose. Mueller investigated it to a fairly well. And by the way, it's the second time an FBI investigation cleared the president of collusion. How many times does he have to be cleared of it? So I would resist those subpoenas and let them fight for anything they get and prove their legitimacy.
And one of the things they want to subpoena is the physical body of Don McCann, former White House counsel. Some of us are asking ourselves, I thought there were two things that were sacred. One was a husband and wife testifying
right
against each other. And the other was that you cannot compel a lawyer to testify against his or her client. So what am I missing? Help me out here. I'm not a lawyer, I'm proud to say. You are. So you help me to understand this.
Well, I find it to be extraordinary. Their requests defy every constitutional norm I can think of. The reality is that Cohen trashed the attorney-client privilege when he taped his client and lied to him about it, and then actually doctored the tape. And there's no reason to interrogate McGahn any longer. He was questioned for 29 hours. He must have given his entire history, going back to birth, for 29 hours. And if Mueller couldn't get out of him what he wanted, It just isn't there. So this becomes now harassment. It becomes really a violation of separation of powers. Congress is going so far here, they are interfering with the ability of the executive branch to function. 81 subpoenas before the report was even filed? I mean, they decided this before they read the report. Jerry Nadler was overheard on the train coming down from New York to Washington plotting an impeachment. And a week ago, one of his aides was heard doing the same thing. So they can go try to fool somebody else, but not Donald Trump.
So I guess I'm having a hard time understanding. An impeachment is not going anywhere, not with the Senate in Republicans' hands, and it's going to be a bigger failure than it was with Bill Clinton in 1998. Why do the Democrats want to push it? Because it actually helped Bill Clinton. Do they not think the same thing will happen with Donald Trump?
And let me make a distinction. Bill Clinton was guilty of a crime. It's called perjury. You know, when the dress was produced, he had to stop lying about it. Otherwise, they'd still be lying about it now, and he and Hillary would be trashing Monica Lewinsky. But he got caught, and he had to admit that he committed perjury, lying under oath. Now, maybe it wasn't serious enough, maybe it was more personal, but it sure was a crime. So in this case, the president was found not to have committed the underlying crime. And the reality is that the president's conduct is easily explainable. This is a man who was falsely accused, and everything they like to say is obstruction, is a man trying to defend himself against very unfair, exaggerated, falsified charges.
Yeah, I think I'd be pretty ticked off if somebody were accusing me of something like that as well. Can't blame him.